Hey guys, so we're gonna do the questions and answers video. I had posted one and y'all asked questions and now we are going to answer them. So the first one is from Mel and MXO, and the question is, what are your favorite movies? And I think, well, you can answer yours and then I'll answer mine.
My favorite movies are lots of guy movies, Beer Fest, Superbad, Hangover, things like that. I also like pretty much anything with Jim Carrey.
And you like action movies too?
A lot of action movies too, but mostly funny guy humor comedies.
And I like The Hangover, and I like a few funny guy movies. I like a few funny guy movies, but I tend to stick with like funny women comedies or like dramatic movies. I can't watch action or horror movies. It freaks me out. So yeah. Number two is from Mel and MXO, and it is, what do you argue about a lot?
Your face.
Your face. He says it all the time. Like, if I ask him a question, baby, what are we having for dinner?
Your face.
It's so irritating. He says little sayings like that all the time, but I mean, I think that's the only thing that we argue about. Yeah. From Jess Zero Shep, the question is, what are some of your hobbies other than YouTube? My favorite hobbies now have been like doing crafty stuff and baking. I have recently started baking and making all kinds of different things, and that has really become one of my hobbies. And yours are?
Running. I'm training for the Austin Marathon.
Fashion Lover 80 asks, what's your favorite drugstore makeup item? And are Wet n Wild and Milani? And what kind of drugstore things do you like? Like men's products?
The Axe hairstyling products are my favorite.
I don't know how to say this name to you. MacBulik asks, what are the, for fall is what I'm assuming you're asking, and my must-haves for fall are like spiky eyelashes and metallics, but I'm still sticking with the neutral eye. I just did a tutorial on it today, and for fashion, mustard colored, it's not really showing on camera, the true, because I'm next to you, but it's mustard colored and creams and stuff like that, and I'll do a separate video, so that's just kind of like a preview. What are your fashion must-haves for fall?
Shoes.
Shoes. Oh my god, shoes. Yes. On my Facebook, the question is, what is your fondest childhood memory? And I'll let you go first.
Little League baseball was a blast. I played for, I think, about 8 or 9 years, and it was awesome. Definitely a lot of fun. I don't think anything could really beat Little League baseball.
And your favorite childhood trip that you went on?
Favorite childhood trip... I went snowboarding a lot when I was a kid, and that was a lot of fun, too. Been to several different places to go snowboarding.
And my fondest childhood memory was going camping. We went camping, and we had a boat, too. So camping and going on the boat was, like, big, and we also went to the beach. So the first went camping, and then that phase kind of, like, went out. And then we went to the beach. Like, we were there every single weekend, every, like, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, we were at the beach. And then we got the jet ski, and we were out on the lake all the time. And I had some really good memories out on the lake. And then when I got older, I was probably 14, I think it was when we first started dating. We went to, not Kevin and I, but my family and I went to New Mexico to see my grandparents, and we went skiing. And I'm not going to go into too much detail because I don't want to embarrass my family members, but there were some seriously funny memories on that skiing trip. And just one of them was Big Bear. Here, do it together. Ready?
Big Bear.
So, that was one of my fondest childhood memories. And the last question is from my YouTube.
Years
and
ago.
Her question was, what was his reaction, talking about Kevin, what was his reaction to the pregnancy, and when did you guys decide you were going to get married? So, we were already engaged. We got engaged in 2007, and I got pregnant that summer. And we had already been looking for places to get married and all of that stuff. We I think we had actually picked out the place that we wanted to get married at. I was just underage, and I couldn't get married unless I had parent consent. And it ended up just working out that we ended up getting married. We'll talk more about that later, but we ended up getting married the next year. So, but we had already decided to get married. I mean, we were engaged to be married, and we're trying to get married that summer, but it just didn't work out. So, his reaction to the pregnancy, from my point of view, we both, I think, knew that I was pregnant. I knew that I was pregnant, and my mom just kept telling me it was stress, and I knew it wasn't stress. I didn't have any morning sickness or anything like that. I just was very tired all the time. And we had gone to Alaska, and I was drinking pickle juice, and my mother-in-law made the comment, "Are you pregnant?" And I was like, "No." And I was. He was going to UT, and I was living in my hometown, and I had gone to a clinic, like a Christian clinic, that was like to help younger women with pregnancy and stuff like that, and they gave me a pregnancy test because all like 15 of my pregnancy tests that I did at home all said negative. So when I went to the clinic, that's when I got my positive pregnancy test, and I took a picture of the pregnancy test and sent it to him, showing him that it was positive. And then I called him and I was like, "You're gonna be a daddy." And then his reaction, he was, "I think you said, 'No way,' or 'Are you kidding,' or something like that." He was excited and nervous, and then I'll let you kind of explain how you felt.
I was sitting there, I think I was writing a paper, doing some homework or something, and when she called me and told me that, I basically just spent the next 3 hours staring at the wall trying to figure out what to do from there, because I was still trying to get myself through college. There were a lot of uncertainties. I was excited, yeah. I love kids. Anybody who knows me knows that I love kids. So I was really looking forward to it, but as a young man, it's like, okay, now what do we do? As far as trying to provide for the family, and how do I get myself through school now, and different things like that. And we ended up pulling it off in the end, but it was really scary to think about for the first few hours.
Everything's going to be on you.
Yeah.
Kind of.
Yeah, I kind of felt like somebody had just taken a car and put it on my shoulders. I called my mom. I was trying to figure out how to tell my mom. I was like, all right, well, I guess there's really only one way to tell, and that's just to say, hey, Brittany's pregnant. So I called her, and I was like, hey, mom, Brittany's pregnant. She said, yeah, I know. Really? Oh, okay, and you're not mad? But she just kind of already knew that Brittany was pregnant. She's an animal like that and could already...
So I'm going to end this video now that I kind of went like on a little rant and, you know, that kind of thing. And if you have any questions that you want to ask and that you want answered, I think that maybe we could start doing this on the weekends, just answering your questions, or maybe I could just answer your questions if you don't have any questions for him. But if you do have a question, leave it down below and I will look at all that stuff. It's getting super hot in here. I will look at all that stuff and pick some questions, if not all of them, and answer them for y'all. I hope that y'all enjoyed, and we will talk to y'all soon. Bye, everyone.
Bye.